area of real estate, wholesale, storage, whatever, notes, lease purchase, my favorite. You go into those web pages and you answer a few questions. You have to be indirect selling. You cannot do direct selling because they'll kick you off. But you can be very stealth and you can go in there like, you know, like the, Alex was just talking about. You go in and you answer a few questions and then you give something away for free, a free contract or my three favorite passages that should be in every mobile home contract. Or here's my new white paper. It's 5 pages on 16 ways to close a deal in 30 days or less, or questions you should ask your realtor. Oh, you make up different things that you believe that audience is interested in, and then they text you or email you. Okay, now, do you have the right to contact them? Yeah, you can do that. Whereas, is let's see if Brent, are you still there? You're muted, buddy.
Yeah, I'm here. That's awesome.
I wanted to give you a plug because I know you're having a seminar next week. And are there seats still available?
No, we don't. We don't have seats. I'm sorry. I had something in June out in Denver, your neck of the woods. It's milkandhoney.com. Anybody wants to reach out, we're going to be driving supercars and talking land investing. I believe that's June 26th and 27th. Thanks for the opportunity. But yeah, me, Joe McCall, and Ray Jung. We put that up for one day, and we were only supposed to have 25 spots and 38 tickets sold. So we might be in a little trouble with Top Golf, but it's okay.
What a good problem to have, right?
Yeah. We're going to get Joe McCall. So
what is that? When you tell an audience, yeah. What did he just do to us? By the way.
If I was doing it on purpose.
If I called up Brent, quick role play here. Brent, hey Brent, I heard about your seminar with Joe McCall and Ray Zhang and about land and man, I want to go to that. I live right nearby. Can you squeeze me in, please?
No, I'm sorry, I can't. We're sold out. I'd love to help you, Claude.
I live 5 minutes away, man. I'll stand up in the back of the room or whatever.
Well, I'm humbled. But I actually do have another event. I'll drop it here in the chat. Use promo code Brent for $500 off. We're going to have all the top industry land guys plus myself out there for 2 days, just telling everything we're doing in land and driving supercars. So if you can jump up, if you can attend that, it's in June in Denver. That's the best time to be in. That's the best time to be in Colorado anyway.
Use a little scarcity now and get me to pay you right now. You know, you missed out on this.
Yeah.
You might miss out on the next one. You wouldn't want to put some, this is called the skin in the game move. We kind of talked about that earlier. Close me right now on that phone call and make money while you're taking a jog in Florida there.
You know, Claude, I'm actually about to put this out to my Landsharks community. We have a few spots left. But if you want to go ahead and purchase your tickets right now, that might be the only way you secure your seat. Is that something you'd want to do now so you don't miss out again?
You mean that June thing will get filled up like the May one that I wanted to go to?
Yeah, it's going to happen probably this evening. Drop the link in the chat as well as a promo code for you because I really like you. Use my name to get $500 off.
Can I give you a credit card now, or can I go in there right now, or text you? Can I send you a Zelle or something like that?
I'm actually on a walk right now, but yeah, go ahead with your credit card. I'll secure your spot.
Boom. How cool. Tell me how cool that would be to sign up somebody while you're taking your morning walk. What emotional.
It happens.
Yes. What emotional trigger did Brent use so well there? What did he use? My favorite one.
Scarcity.
Scarcity. Everybody together. 1, 2, 3. Scarcity. How powerful is, Justin, you got to chime in on, how powerful is scarcity when you're talking to people like Brent just did? How powerful is that?
Everybody wants what they can't have. Ooh, or what they're afraid again. They might, what they're afraid they might lose out the opportunity to have. So everybody wants what they cannot have or can't, or they're afraid they can't get.
Is that powerful? If you play it right, like Brent was like pushing me, sorry, we're full. I was begging him, literally begging him. I told him I'd even stay in the back room. And he kept, the more he told me I couldn't have what I had, what I wanted, the more I wanted it, didn't I? Do you think real estate, you think those of us in real estate, do you think we could use that scarcity strategy too?
Absolutely.
Hey, Justin, I just wanted to make sure you were on that real estate group thing on Facebook. Did you get my mind map about land investment? I just wanted to make sure. I hope you don't mind me calling you.
I did. I got that. Okay. Good. Thank you for that.
Oh, that's great, man. Listen, how long you been? Are you just getting into land? Before I go, I'm very busy today. But before I go, have you invested in land before? Have you done anything like that, or you been years of experience?
Yeah, I haven't invested in raw land before. No.
Oh, okay.
But I'm interested in it because of the passive income that it creates.
Oh. When you say passive income, what's the dream?
Well, my dream is to get paid every single day of my life. I know that sounds really far out, but you know, when I hear you guys talk about how you've got your businesses running, it makes me want to have that too.
And what would you need to, what do you do for a living now?
Right now I'm an investor, but in the pretty house, I just do pretty houses. So, you know, like I'm assigning all of my deals. And so that means I get nice big shots in the arm. I make nice big checks, but then I have to start over tomorrow.
Oh, okay. And you said the passive income. What kind of passive income? Where are you now? Where would you like to be in terms of passive income? If you don't mind me asking before I leave.
Right now, I don't have a lot of passive income, but I would love to have, like I said, like I saw Brent the other day. He's got money coming in like every day.
Yeah. What do you mean? $100, $1,000 a day, $5,000, $20,000 a month?
I mean, anywhere from $20 to $2,000. I mean, that would, you know, it all adds up. It's kind of like, you know, getting something every day. It really, really stacks up quick.
If you got to, let's say, $2,500, $5,000 a month, just for starters, how would that wouldn't change your life, would it?
Oh, well, yeah, definitely. And better than that, learning the process of how to make it happen so I can just rinse and repeat. Yes.
Can you imagine if you found a system where you could find the properties, you could finance them, you could assign them, wholesale them, you could hold on to a few and watch them appreciate on that? I don't know. That may not be what you're looking for.
That is exactly what I'm looking for.
What am I, my students out there, good role play. What am I doing here? Am I giving him a presentation or just asking questions with a little imagery? How important is it to put the ideas, the pictures in their head and to get those needs and greeds? How important is that? It's huge.
Yeah.
Just going back to what Nitzan said, though, I called up Justin before. Do I have, when I give answers on social media, when I give things away, when I give people my time for consultation, do I have the right, the tacit approval is the legal term, to call them back or to text them or to initiate a contact? Do I have that right? Isn't it easy to call somebody back? Corey DiGiacomo. Hey, Corey. Hey, Corey, I just wanted to make sure you asked a question on Facebook the other day, and I thank you, and I sent you some stuff and everything. Did I answer your question okay?
Yeah, I was trying to get some information, so I was wanted to reach out and see if I could get some time.
Why are you interested in solar heating and everything like that? I was just curious. Why did you bring that up?
I've just been looking at different opportunities, different kind of vetting different people and trying to get information.
Okay. Boom. Is this, we're out of time here, but do you see who loves easy, warm phone calls? Everybody, right? Okay. Who wants to do cold calls? I don't mind taking a cold call and making it into a warm call. But when I have somebody that I met online and I get back to them, and you can use LinkedIn and all these different social media, and you can leave voicemails too. We talk about that all the time. You have to leave the guts style voicemail so you get a very We get a high percentage of return calls if you leave the right voicemail. But when you're when you're giving away information or participating online, maybe 30 minutes a day, you can develop your own warm call lead system. And these calls are so much more fun. There's no pressure when you're coming back, when you're calling somebody back to ask for their opinion, make sure they got the product or service. Hey, did I answer your question? Is there about 20 different ways to open a conversation with somebody? And where can that lead to? A sale.
Business.
Sale.
Hey, Claude, one thing I'm going to start doing more of, which I don't see anybody else doing this, is doing actual deals live, personally with my team, actually showing the ins and outs and the things we go through as deal creators and deal makers and deal finders. You could probably get more leads than you want that way, as far as people wanting to come into your program. If you physically do deals live, show what you're spending, what you're putting as far as time, and also what you make. You know, some people just think it's magic or it's not attainable, but I think just being vulnerable like that is going to get more potential applications for your program.
And what happens if that's a really honest way. See, your competition, pardon the expression, does not have the guts to do that, because what can happen on those live phone calls?
Yeah, you can make a mistake, a huge mistake, big mistakes, or you can, like, I just made a huge mistake the other day on a land deal and I'm sharing it. It's public. I'm going to hopefully dig my way out of it, but I'm sharing it. I just hired an attorney last week. I had to spend money on a piece of land that could be worthless now because I made a simple mistake.
Yeah. I think people are looking for accountability. They're looking, I think too many of our competitors out there are not giving people the customer service they want, the accountability, the follow-up that they're looking for. I love follow-up, okay? Certain things, it's not always about the price, is it? Isn't it about that somebody has your back and you feel good about them? How big is that in making commitments? When they feel so good about you and the services you provide and you follow up with them right away. Okay. Has anybody here ever contacted a contractor? Oh, I got my car lease. Okay. I lease a car every 2 years. Okay. I sent a couple dealerships. I knew the make and model and everything. And I said, here's my phone number and everything else. Do you know two of the car dealerships never got back to me? And I gave him my phone number. Can you imagine that? I mean, that to me, that's crazy. You have a customer who contacts you, and then you're so scared to giving good phone that you want to text. You cannot text an email all day long in your marketing. There's a lot of people who want that.